Hello friends, welcome to our channel Nursing Tutor. In this video, we will discuss about blood gas analysis. Let's see the introduction about ABG. Blood gas analysis is often used to identify the specific acid-base disturbance and the degree of compensation that has occurred. The analysis is usually based on an arterial blood sample. But if an arterial sample cannot be obtained, a mixed venous sample may be used. Result of arterial blood gas analysis provide information about alveolar ventilation, oxygenation, and acid-base balance. It is necessary to evaluate the concentrations of serum electrolytes such as sodium, potassium, and chloride, and carbon dioxide. The health history, physical examination, previous blood gas result, and serum electrolytes should always be the part of assessment used to determine the cause of the acid-base disorder. Next, we are going to talk about four important components that are in your ABG. Those are pH, CO2 or carbon dioxide, HCO3 or bicarbonate, PaO2 or oxygen. Okay, we know the four important components in our ABG. Let's see the normal values for arterial blood. First one is pH. The normal value of pH is 7.35 to 7.45. Second one is partial pressure of carbon dioxide. The normal value of PaCO2 is 35 to 45 mmHg. Next one is bicarbonate. HCO3. The normal value of HCO3 is 22 to 26 milliequivalents per liter. Partial pressure of oxygen is 80 to 100 mmHg. The normal oxygen saturation is 94 to 100%. First, we will see pH of arterial blood. Arterial blood pH, which indicates the amount of hydrogen ions in blood. The normal pH is 7.35 to 7.45. If the pH value is less than 7.35, means acidity, and the pH value is greater than 7.45 is alkaline. A lower blood pH may indicate that your blood is more acidic and has higher carbon dioxide levels. A higher blood pH may indicate that your blood is more basic and has a higher bicarbonate level. Second one is PaCO2. PaCO2 is partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is gas, so this PaCO2 indicates the lungs condition. The normal value of PaCO2 is 35 to 45 mmHg. If the value is less than 35, means base, and if the value is greater than 45, means acidic. Next one is HCO3. The normal value of HCO3 is 22 to 26 milliequivalents per liter. The HCO3 or bicarbonate indicates condition of kidney. If the level is less than 22, it means acidic, and greater than 26 indicates base. Okay guys, now we know what are the normal values and which is acidic and which is alkaline. Next, we will see the ABG interpretation. ABG interpretation has three steps. First one is identify if it is acidosis or alkalosis. See the pH level. Second one is identify if it is respiratory or metabolic. See the carbon dioxide levels and bicarbonate levels. Third one is if it is compensated or uncompensated. First one is identify if it is acidosis or alkalosis. We know the normal pH level is 7.35 to 7.45. If less than 7.35 indicates acidosis and greater than 7.45 indicates alkalosis. Example, if the pH value is 7.23, means that condition is acidic. Second one is identify if it is respiratory or metabolic. This is concept method. PSCO2 normal value is 35 to 45 mmHg. That PSCO2 or partial pressure of carbon dioxide indicates lungs condition. HCO3 normal value is 22 to 26 milliequivalents per liter. This bicarbonate levels indicates kidney condition. So, if PaCO2 is abnormal, HCO3 is normal means that condition is respiratory. If the HCO3 is abnormal and the PaCO2 is normal, then the condition is definitely metabolic condition. Let's see some examples. Example 1. pH value is 7.23. PaCO2 is 52. HCO3 is 23. 7.23 is the low pH, so it is acidic. PaCO2 is abnormal, that is high level, so it indicates respiratory condition. HCO3 is 23 normal. So this condition is respiratory acidosis. Second example, pH value is 7.5, PaCO2 is 30. HCO3 is 22. pH 7.5 is high, so it indicates alkalosis. PaCO2 30 is low from normal, so it indicates respiratory. HCO3 is normal. So this example indicates respiratory alkalosis. Second example, metabolic condition. pH value is 7.2, PaCO2 is 37, HCO3 is 21. pH 7.23 is low, so it is acidic. PaCO2 normal, then HCO3 is 21, that is low from normal, that indicates metabolic. So this condition is metabolic acidosis. Second example, pH 7.56, PaCO2 41, HCO3 35. pH 7.5 is high from normal, so it is alkalosis. PaCO2 41 normal, HCO3 35 is high from normal, so it is metabolic condition, so it is metabolic alkalosis. If the PaCO2 and HCO3 are abnormal, what will happen? In these conditions, compensation will occur. That is the third step. If the pH is not within or close to the normal ranges, then a partial compensation exists. If the pH is back within normal ranges, then a full compensation that has occurred. A non-compensated or uncompensated abnormality usually represents an acute change occurring in our body. Compensation. The first thing, you want to remember the normal values of arterial blood. See this table. Acidotic, alkalotic, pH 7.35 to 7.45, PaCO2 45 to 35. This PaCO2 values are the opposite, so remember that. HCO3 22 to 26. Now, when you are dealing with full compensation, you will have to further analyze the blood pH value to determine if it is a respiratory or metabolic problem. In full compensation, the blood pH will be normal, but you must determine if the value is on the acidotic side or alkalotic side. How do you do this? Remember that the absolute normal for a blood pH is 7.40. Look at the picture below for an illustration. And the normal range for a blood pH is 7.35 to 7.45. Therefore, if the blood pH falls between 7.35 to 7.4, it is on acidotic side. And if the blood pH falls between 7.4 to 7.45, it is on alkalotic side. In this table, we can see some examples. Blood pH levels, bicarbonate levels, partial pressure of carbon dioxide, and conditions, common causes. Blood pH is less than 7.4. Bicarbonate levels are low. PaCO2 levels are low means the condition is metabolic acidosis. The common causes are kidney failure, shock, diabetic, and ketoacidosis. If the pH value is 7.4, bicarbonate levels are high. Partial pressure of carbon dioxide levels are high means the condition is metabolic alkalosis. The common causes are chronic vomiting, low blood potassium. Blood pH is less than 7.4. Bicarbonate levels are high. PaCO2 levels are high means the condition is respiratory acidosis. The common causes are lung diseases including pneumonia or COPD. If the blood pH is greater than 7.4 and the bicarbonate levels are low, partial pressure of carbon dioxide levels are low, the condition is respiratory alkalosis and the common causes are breathing too fast, pain and anxiety. In detail about full compensation and partial compensation, we will see in one more video. Thank you for watching, friends. Please subscribe our channel for more videos. If you want any specific topic, please comment below that. Thank you.